This is our lecture number 11, and we will talk today about the application of Diophantine equation. Diophantine equation technique offers you a way around right-hand side zeros of the controlled plant. In the very beginning of control system design, I mentioned to you that the controlled plant shall not have right-hand side zeros because, if you remember, we're supposed to cancel zeros of the plant in order to get control over the overshoot. The left-hand side zeros we can cancel all right, but the right-hand side zeros cannot be canceled because this would require a unstable filter. And nobody wants to have an unstable filter in a control system. The Diophantine equation basically is a purely algebraic approach. Without any difference, it could be used in a discrete time control, in continuous time control. Diophantine equation is best presented in the classical sense, in terms of transfer functions, not in the state variable definition. So let's go over the Diophantine equation technique. First of all, you can see a control system. It has a controlled plant. The controlled plant is defined by a transfer function. This is the polynomial numerator of the controlled plant, numerator p. P stands for plant. This is the polynomial denominator of the controlled plant. Now, let's assume that there are right-hand side zeros in the transfer function of the controlled plant. This is why we will be using the technique that will be presented later. The feedback controller, not state variable controller, but a conventional feedback controller, has polynomial numerator NC, C stands for controller, and polynomial denominator DC. And this is the filter in the reference channel. It has the polynomial numerator and F stands for filter, N stands for numerator, and the polynomial denominator, G. But this G has subscript C because the polynomial denominator of the controlled plant is exactly the same as the polynomial denominator of the feedback controller. Why is the output of the control plant and the output of our control system? U is the control effort applied to the control plant, and R is the reference signal. We will assume that numerator is a mth order polynomial, denominator is a nth order polynomial, numerator of the controller and denominator of the controller, as I said, are polynomials. Numerator of the filter is a polynomial. Now, there are many characteristics representing performance of a closed loop system: the settling time, the bandwidth, etc. But in this particular approach, we will use a special model, transfer function of the desired closed-loop system. We call it model transfer function. This model transfer function, unlike the controlled plant, is only a subroutine in the a flight control computer, for example, doesn't have any hardware in it, and it is described by this transfer function with the numerator of the model, polynomial numerator, and polynomial denominator of the model. The output of the model is output y, and the reference of the model is exactly the same reference that is applied to the input of our control system. By the way, by seeing that reference is the input signal, we can get additional reason to understand that this is a desired closed-loop system transfer function, because control effort is the internal variable that will never be seen in the desired closed-loop transfer function. The next, what we have to do, is to apply the Diofantina equation technique. And I prefer to simplify my presentation using very specific polynomial of numerator of the control plant and very specific polynomial denominator of the control plant. So look, I am assuming that our system is a fourth order system. The numerator of the control plant is a third order polynomial. Now what I did, I solved this polynomial equation. I got system roots that happen to be the zeros of the control plant. And look what, we have a right-hand side zero equal to plus 2. Right-hand side zero of the plant is plus 2. I'm doing the same thing with the polynomial denominator. I solved the appropriate equation. I got the poles of the control plant, and I rewrote this polynomial through poles of the control plant. I want to tell you that this right-hand side zero of the control plant later, through the design, will offer some significant difficulties when we will try to achieve the required system overshoot. Now it is time to formulate a model that describes the desired closed-loop performance of our system. And I want to tell you the following. The right-hand side zero of the control plant that we cannot cancel must be included in the model transfer function. So you see this term S minus 2. This is exactly the right-hand side, the term responsible for the right-hand side zero. How high order of this model should be? You know, you want to keep it simple. So I wouldn't have excessively high order for the model, but at the same time, I want to have a sufficient number of adjustable parameters. In this case, parameter B, parameter A1, parameter A2, parameter A3, parameter A4, and parameter K, the constant gain. Why? Because let's assume we have design specs that calling for settling time under 5 seconds and overshoot under 2%. Now, if I would specify the model transfer function by equation like this, I should be able to adjust using my experience, using my intuition, and you will be doing the same thing using your experience and your intuition. There is a mathematical, numerical way of doing it, but at this point we will not go there. We will use our intuition to come up with parameter K, parameter B, parameter A1, A2, A3, and A4 to get the step response for the model that will have settling time under 5 seconds and overshoot under 2%. How you do it? Experimentally, I guess you have to do it. Now, can you handle the situation with the less adjustable parameters? Probably you can. However, if you will be having difficulties achieving these requirements with the parameters that are presented here, you can always have additional parameters added because it costs you nothing. Well, except complexity, of course. Listen, I utilized my professional skills to come up with the numerical values for the parameters that I mentioned earlier in order to have this type of step response for the model. If you will take a close look at this step response, you will agree that the overshoot is close to zero, or actually zero in this case, that the settling time is around 4 seconds, and surely less than 5 seconds. And the set of parameters that offer me this step response is minus 20, minus 3, minus 1, minus 4, minus 5, and minus 6. But then you have to note the following. This is called undershoot, not overshoot, but undershoot. Where this undershoot is coming from? Undershoot, generally speaking, is the penalty for having a right-hand side zero in the control plane that eventually will become right-hand side zero of the model. Now, it's up to you to invest more time and minimize this undershoot. And as a matter of fact, this undershoot could be driven to almost zero. So in a technical system, it will have no role. I did not want to invest too much time. I am assuming that this undershoot does not contradict customer specifications, and I will keep it here. But again, if I would keep adjusting this parameter and this parameter and this parameter and parameter that is now minus 5 and minus 6 and minus 3, I probably will be able to reduce the undershoot. Now, the Diophantine procedure requires me to split numerator of the plant, the polynomial numerator of the plant, into two terms. This is the numerator of the plant, the polynomial, and I have to split it into the good part, numerator plant with plus, and the bad part, responsible for the right-hand side zeros. And, of course, you don't have to be a rocket scientist to figure out that the good part of the numerator of the plant that does not contribute to right-hand side zeros is this, and I can turn it into a second-order polynomial, and the numerator of the plant with minus is s minus 2. This is the term responsible for the right-hand side zeros. The next what we have to do is this. The numerator of the model. You can see it right here. The numerator of the model, I have to split. And it's very easy to do, because this is how we define the numerator of the model. The numerator of the model will have numerator of the plant with minus and numerator of the model with asterisk. And it's very easy to figure out that the numerator of the model consists of s minus 2 term, and it consists of minus 3 times s plus 20. And I wrote it right here. This is the numerator of the model with asterisk. It does not contribute to bad zeros. It's equal to minus 3s plus 60. Minus 3 comes inside of this parenthesis, and this is what we get. Now, the denominator of the model is written right here. We established it in order to satisfy design specs by the step response of the model. And I just converted it into a polynomial format. The next what we will do, let's work on the closed loop transfer function of our control system. The closed loop transfer function, I will call it G of S. First of all, it has the transfer function of the filter, because filter is placed in series with the loop. So indeed, this is the transfer function of the filter. And this is our control loop. It has the transfer function of the control plant in the numerator, divided by 1 plus transfer function of the control plant times transfer function of the feedback controller. And if I would do some simplifications, this is the result that I will get. In the numerator, I have numerator of the filter times numerator of the plant. In the denominator, I have denominator of the plant times denominator of the controller plus numerator of the plant times numerator of the controller. Polynomial denominator of the controller does not exist yet. And polynomial numerator of the controller does not exist yet. We have to establish them. What I will do now, I will assume that the denominator of the controller, although it's not defined, I will assume that it includes good part of the numerator of the plant times denominator of the controller with asterisk. This part is known, but this part is unknown to us, and we will work on it. Well, why can we make this type of assumption? This denominator does not exist, so I guess we can make any assumptions we want. And if I would make this assumption, I want you to realize I will insert this expression right here. And what will happen is this. Transfer function was defined, numerator of the filter, numerator of the plant, divided by denominator of the plant, denominator of the controller, numerator of the plant, numerator of the controller. But now what I do is this. I still have numerator of the filter, but numerator of the plant I split into two parts. The good part with plus and the bad part with minus. Denominator of the plant is still sitting here. But this is how the denominator of the controller was defined. It was defined as numerator of the plant with plus times denominator of the controller with asterisk. It's this expression is inserted here. Here, numerator of the plant, I split in two parts, the good part and the bad part, and this is the numerator of the controller that I still do not have. And then, of course, I will do the cancellation. I will cancel numerator of the plant with plus. It's not here anymore. I will cancel it from this part of the denominator, and I cancel it from another part of the denominator. And now I want you to take a close look at this transfer function. Numerator of the filter is not known. Numerator of the plant with minus is known. Denominator of the plant is known. Denominator of the controller with asterisk is unknown. Numerator of the plant with minus is known. and the numerator of the controller is unknown. Let's take a look at this part. This is the transfer function of the closed loop system with the filter, with the controller, with everything what it has. Right here. The same expression in this one. Now, what do we want to happen? It's very natural. We want this closed loop transfer function to be equal to the transfer function of the model. This is the purpose of our design. If this will happen, if we will achieve this condition, then I guess our design goal will be reached, will be achieved. But then I want to remind you that for the numerator of the model, the definition is the bad part of the numerator of the plant times numerator of the model with asterisk. And, my friends, if this part should be equal to this part, I can cancel numerator of the plant with minus. Numerator of the plant with minus could be canceled. And now, what we're getting is this bare minimum that what we have from the definition of the closed-loop transfer function. This is numerator of the filter. This is denominator of the plant known to us. This is the denominator of the controller with asterisk that we do not have yet. This is the bad part of the numerator of the plant, and this is the numerator of the controller that we have to determine. It must be equal to numerator of the model with asterisk divided by the denominator of the model with asterisk. And I surely can, in this expression, multiply the numerator and the denominator by the same polynomial that I call a zero. For what reason it is done? I'll tell you exactly for what reason. You know, if I will, let's take a look at this expression and this expression. At this point, this is a ratio, and this is a ratio. And if one ratio is equal to another ratio, it does not mean that I can equate this numerator to this numerator, and I can equate this denominator to this denominator. The order of the polynomial numerator, order of polynomial numerator, order of polynomial denominator, and order of this polynomial denominator could be quite different. However, to eliminate this difference, I can introduce polynomial A0. Polynomial A0. And now, with the polynomial A0, not only this ratio will be equal to this ratio, I will have numerator of this ratio will be equal to the numerator of the ratio in the right-hand side. And the same thing, denominator of this ratio will become equal to the denominator of the ratio in the right-hand side. Okay, so I'm equating one ratio to another, but in order to equate one numerator to another numerator and another one denominator to another denominator, I need this additional polynomial A0. Now, this equality and this equality could be achieved. Now, polynomial A0, we will define ourselves. Denominator of the model has been defined. Denominator of the plant is known. Polynomial N minus of the plant, the bad part of the polynomial of the plant, is known. We have two unknown polynomials, G, she with asterisk, and N, she. And they should be found, and they could be found, from this equation. And this equation is known as the Diophantine equation. Diophantine equation. And if in the Diophantine equation you will properly choose order of polynomial a 0, you will get the solution. You will get polynomial g controller asterisk and n controller. Now, what we have to do at this point is to assume a particular configuration for the polynomial g controller asterisk. I will define it in this form. Its order is k, not discussing this part yet. Let's leave k alone at this point. But this is the polynomial denominator of the controller with asterisk. I want you to note, please, that the coefficient of the highest order of s is 1. It must be 1. Otherwise, the Diophantine technique wouldn't work for you. So this is how you define the polynomial G controller with asterisk. And we'll find these coefficients, no problem. Now, I will suggest this configuration for the polynomial NC, numerator of the controller. And I want you to note that L is, we are not sure about L at this point, order of the polynomial. But please note that the coefficient of S in the highest order is not 1. It could be changed, doesn't have to be. Well, shall not be 1, let me put it this way. Now it is time to talk about polynomial a0. Polynomial a0, I will define in this way. And I want you to note that this is a mistake. This shall be J, capital J. Now it is correct. Yeah, polynomial A0 is defined by you and me, and the order of this polynomial is capital J. How to define the polynomial A0? First of all, roots of the polynomial A0 shall be non-dominant. So, if they would be roots of the closed loop system, they shall not affect system settling time. They should be non-dominant roots. And they must be left-hand side roots also. So, the polynomial A0 is chosen such that it contains non-dominant terms in sense of control system dynamics, and it must shall not have right-hand side, must have left-hand side roots, polynomial A0. And now it is time to look into some recommendations established by the Diophantine technique. Let's take a look at the order of the polynomial A0. I'm talking about J. Order of the polynomial A0 should be greater equal to times order of the controlled plant, order of the denominator of the control, minus order of the denominator of the model. minus order of the good part of the polynomial of the plant, minus 1. Where this comes from? From purely algebraic considerations. If you will have different considerations, you may never get the solution. The second requirement on the order of polynomials is this: order of the denominator of the model minus order of the numerator of the model should be greater or equal than order of the denominator of the plant minus order of the numerator of the plant. What this means effectively? This means that the difference between number of poles and number of zeros in the model should be greater equal than the difference between the number of poles and number of zeros of the control plant. This is not a big deal. So, in our example, order of the denominator of the plant was 4. Order of the denominator of the model was also 4. Order of the good polynomial of the plant is 2. And therefore, order of polynomial a0j cannot be less than 1. And let's choose it, j equal to 2. So the polynomial a0, according to our choice, will be a second order polynomial. This polynomial is supposed to have roots that will be in the left-hand side of the complex plane and for all practical purposes shall be non-dominant. And I chose minus 10 and minus 12. They are non-dominant, all right. And this is polynomial a0. Now, can we check the second requirement? Order of the denominator of the model is 4. Order of the numerator of the model is 2. The difference is 2. Order of the denominator of plant is 4. Order of the numerator of the plant is 3. I guess our requirements are successfully met. And now I am ready to write down the Diophantine equation. The Diophantine equation supposed to have the numerator of the plant, and you have it right here written, times the polynomial denominator of the controller with asterisk. This is what it is, denominator of the controller with asterisk, defined by a polynomial. Then I am supposed to have plus. This is the bad part of the numerator of the plant times the numerator of the controller. If you remember, I provided this format for the numerator of the controller. And it shall be equal to the denominator of the model times polynomial a0. I want you to keep in mind, in the right-hand side, I have 6-order polynomial. When I will multiply this, I will get a 6-order polynomial. I also have to tell you that in the right-hand side, coefficient of s in the power of 6 will be equal to 1. It is very important to us. Now, what do we have in the left-hand side? In the left-hand side, this sum should be equal to a 6-order polynomial as well. Now, we can make a provision for this. First of all, if I will choose k equal to 2, then surely in the left-hand side, I will have s in the power of 6 multiplied by 1. So at least this part in the left-hand side and in the right-hand side will be properly defined. And therefore, I have in front of you the configuration for the whole configuration of the polynomial g controller with asterisk. It is s squared plus delta 1 times s plus delta 0. So this polynomial is a second order polynomial. And it has two unknown coefficients, delta 1 and delta 0. This is very easy to visualize. Let's take a look at this term. It's our goal to have six-order polynomial in the left-hand side and six-order polynomial in the right-hand side. How would we make sure that these polynomials are equal? Well, coefficient of s in the power of 6 in the left-hand side and right-hand side should be the same. It's already the same, by the way, it's 1. Coefficient of s in the power of 5 in the left-hand side and right-hand side should be the same, and so on. To achieve this, we have to choose properly delta 1, delta 0, but then, how many equations do we have to satisfy? We have to satisfy total of 6 equations. Because don't worry about coefficients of s in the power of 6 in the left-hand side and right-hand side to be the same. They are already the same. But then we have s coefficient of s in the power of 5, s in the power of 4, s in the power of 3, s in the power of... s in the power of 2, s in the power of 1, and s in the power of 0. So it looks like we have to satisfy total of 6 equations by choosing coefficients delta 1, delta 0, and then what? 4 more coefficients we need. It should be beta 3, beta 2, beta 1, and beta 0. So now I have the order for the polynomial numerator of the controller. The rest what I have to do is to work on solving a set of equations that would provide delta 1, delta 0, beta 3, beta 2, beta 1, and beta 0. So I have 6 unknowns, and I will have 6 equations. Again, these equations are defined as coefficients of s in the power of 5, power of 4, and so on, in the left-hand side and right-hand side. Yep, this is the story, and I told you this story. Yeah, I established with you that the polynomial g asterisk should be second order, and very soon you will agree with me that polynomial numerator of the controller should be third order, and then what we have to do, we have to honestly establish equations that should be solved. And these equations will contain delta 1, delta 0, delta 1, delta 0, beta 3, beta 2, beta 1, beta, and so on. And I can build this matrix equation. Okay? We are very good with solving matrix equations now. the notations are self-explanatory. If I would solve, this is the zero order terms, or right hand side. Look, if I will introduce special name for this matrix, matrix theta, and special name for this matrix, 5, and if x will be this vector of unknown coefficients, and psi will be this column, you have to solve this equation. Do you really have to go through the pain of writing these equations? The answer is no. First of all, you may find a software tool that does it for you. Okay? There are software tools that solve Jeff-Hansen equation, and they are available in MATLAB. They are available in my software CC that I'm using for a very long time. But I also created my own rule. And I guess you have to follow this rule. This rule was checked by a couple of advanced students of mine. And this rule eliminates the headache of building these equations. It's still a minor headache, but minor headache. This rule tells you how to establish matrix phi, how to establish column theta, and how to establish column psi. And then you have to solve the Jeff-Hansen equation. And you can see the example right here for our problem. But when you will solve for coefficients delta 1 and delta 0, you have to recall that they are coefficients of polynomial denominator controller with asterisk. And denominator of the controller should be equal to the good polynomial part of the numerator of the plant times denominator of the controller with asterisk. So you're getting this result. And this is the summary of our design. Now, how to handle the filter and the reference channel? The filter and the reference channel should be the let me go back and we'll show you where it's coming from. Look, numerator of the filter. Look at the numerator of the filter. The numerator of the filter should be equal to numerator of the model with asterisk, which means the good part of the numerator of the model, times polynomial A0. This is the numerator of the filter. Where is the denominator of the filter? Well, as you remember, the denominator of the filter must be equal to the denominator of the controller. So this is the solution. And this is the final result. Final result. Now, if you want, you can obtain... use the controller, use the plant, and use the prefilter, and you can get the closed-loop transfer function of the system, and it will be exactly equal to the transfer function of the model. Nothing could be done successfully without verifying your design by computer simulation. Solving the Jeff-Hansen equation and not supporting your solution by simulation is very counterproductive. I want you to do at least one and better couple of complete examples where you start from the controlled plant with the bad zeros and design specs, build the model, make sure that the model satisfies the design specifications, and then proceed with the Diophantine design. And there is an appendix that shows more examples featuring the application of the Diophantine procedure, but they also demonstrate the application of the suggested rule for building equations, matrix equations for Diophantine solution. So this is the problem that you have to solve as a part of your homework assignment. At this point, I covered all the material that you will be facing in your test number one, or in your midterm. And let me explain why. I probably should include more material, but I want you to realize that without the use of computer tools, a lot of things are meaningless. If you just use paper and pencil, it is very counterproductive for your control background. You must understand the theory, but I'm not going to ask theoretical questions in the midterm. In the midterm, there will be something that one can do in class with a scientific computer, paper, and pencil. So, what do you have to prepare for the test, for the midterm? First of all, you have to be very skillful and very knowledgeable in converting state variable definition to a transfer function and converting transfer function to various forms of state variable definitions. You should be able to convert, and you must remember how to convert arbitrary form to CCF, how to convert CCF to diagonalized, how to convert arbitrary form to diagonalized form. This is a very important part. The second issue, you have to be very confident in working with the state transition matrix. All right? State transition matrix could be used in order to get initial conditions if you have current conditions, or get current conditions if you have initial conditions. Conditions could be defined in different state variable definitions. Sometimes it is allowable to get approximate solution. Sometimes you must get the exact solution, and you should be able to know what you do. The second problem is control system design, the pole placement procedure. And you should be proficient with the pole placement procedure. You should know how to satisfy design specs, how to check how design specs or how well design specs are satisfied, and so on and so forth. The next, you have to be able to handle the situation when you have to build a state variable controller, but state variables are not accessible. You know that it requires a state observer. How to handle the state observer part? You know, I provided you with the formula for this, but if it's only a second order system, you will be much better off doing it in the very straightforward way. You don't have to use the recursive approach that I proposed. For a third, fourth, fifth order system, it makes sense, but for a second order system, you can handle the situation in a more simple way. And then, of course, you have to know how to handle the differential equation. It does not mean that I will ask you to solve fifth, tenth order differential equation in class, but still there are a good old-fashioned way to find out if a student knows or a student does not know how to use the differential equation. I want to emphasize that this midterm is very important for your grade because the difference in grades, the variability will come from midterm. When you will be doing your take-home final, you will have unlimited time to do it. And if you do more or less well in class, and especially if you can get help from other people, I hope it wouldn't happen, but the grades of the final will not vary that much. Keep this in mind. Because, as I said, you will have unlimited time to get an almost perfect result. But for the midterm, it's a 1 hour, 25 minutes under the watchful eye of Ming and other people whom I bring to monitor, and I probably will be myself there. So look, take it seriously.